Hey, Cross Gates, time for our midweek update, and I am sitting in a different chair in my office because I wanted y'all to see something. I am now a warehouse for bicycles. I want to say thank you for all of the individual members of our church who have selectively joined in this bike drive that we're helping the Church of Philadelphia Philadelphia Ministries, Pastor Stacy Brown. And, you know, we as a church have a partnership, or we're building a partnership with him and his congregation. And for those of you who don't know, he is their church is now in the former Trinity United Methodist Church on Clinton Boulevard in West Jackson. And Stacy and I, Pastor Brown and I, reconnected a couple of years ago. We hadn't seen each other since high school, and neither one of us knew that that we had gotten called into ministry. But he is serving a congregation there, and we met, and we decided to find a partnership. And so this church, Cross Gates, has been very generous and gracious in all sorts of different tangible ways of partnership. So in a few minutes, I'm going to be getting in my car and going and purchasing about five or six more bikes. Several members have just made a cash donation instead of actually getting the bike. But that's the update today. I just wanted to say thank you for the joy that you have in your hearts, for the joy that you bring to others, for all the various ways that we show love in small and tangible ways, and sometimes just through a bicycle. Yesterday, the Salvation Army came and picked up a hallway full of our Angel Tree gifts that the members had selected. So again, pastoring a church like this, I can't say it's always easy because of the business side of things, but from the ministry side, from the way that I see Christ at work, moving and living among us and transforming us and creating new life in us, it's beautiful. So just wanted to say thank you for that, for the joy that it erupts. One small announcement, this Sunday evening, we are going to have a Carols and Cocoa out at the prayer chapel, and we'll have the fire pits lit and sing some Christmas carols and have hot cocoa, and I think we're even going to try to have schmores. So notice how I said that. I just realized schmores. I think they're pronounced s'mores, but today they're schmores. Parents, just be prepared. If you do or do not want your children to be covered in marshmallows, chocolate, and graham crackers. So just 5 o'clock this coming Sunday evening, just an opportunity to gather, sing songs, sing some carols, fellowship with one another in the name of Christ, and just have some fun. So this Sunday is joy. This Sunday is the Sunday we light the joy candle, and it's an opportunity for us to remember that joy comes because of God's initiative, but joy comes also out of repentance. And it's the funniest for me juxtaposition of texts of these prophets, Zephaniah and Isaiah, and even Paul in Philippians is talking about rejoice in the Lord, sing aloud, enjoy, do these things. And then you have John the Baptist coming up, and you can almost see him pointing his finger and saying, repent, you brood of vipers. And so, but it will make sense, I promise. So stay tuned. Come to worship on Sunday, or participate as our Cross Gates at Home congregation, and be ready to come and learn about joy through the lens of John the Baptist. But again, it's been a very interesting week this week with all sorts of different things going on. But Cross Gates, I celebrate what God is doing among us. In the midst of the busyness and distractions and difficulties and things that we sometimes wish didn't happen, and honestly, some stuff that we just keep hidden because we don't want our friends and neighbors to know just how difficult life can be, reach out and extend your hand to one another, and reach out in joy, even when you don't feel it. Joy is not something that we create on our own. Joy is a gift from God that erupts out of us in the worst and darkest of times. So be prepared this Sunday for joy to erupt. I'll leave us on this in midweek update with just a short reading from Paul when he says to his friends in Philippi. This is not a text that we should read when life gets difficult and impose it on others. This is a text that we should read for ourselves. But this is Philippians 4:4-7. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I'll say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication. With thanksgiving, let your requests be known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Crossgates, you hear me say a lot, I see Christ in you. The reason why I say it is not because of anything that you're doing to make it happen. It's because that God is at work in us in Christ to transform and guard our hearts. So continue to lean into Him, trust Him, engage, do get into the joyful dance with the Holy Spirit. But trust what God is doing. Wait and see what God's going to do. Pray at all times. Be gentle to everyone, because everyone's got something that they're going through. A little bit of rambly midweek update, but Crossgates, I do want you to know I love you, and I'm proud of you, and I'm proud of what God is doing in you. I see Christ in you. I'll see you on Sunday.